Welcome to the Basic Civil Engineering Lecture Series by Roy M. Thomas.
Hi friends, I am Roy M. Thomas. Today we will discuss Module 3, Leveling.
Leveling. What is leveling? Leveling is the art of finding the relative heights of points on the surface of the earth. Actually, it is a part of surveying which deals with the measurements in vertical plane. The instruments used in leveling. The first one is level. There are different types of levels called dummy level, tilting level, automatic level, Y level, etc. The commonly using level is the dummy level. And the second one is the leveling staff. Actually, it is a scale of say 4 meter height. Now I will show these two instruments. So this is a dummy level. I will explain the different parts. So this is the telescope, and this one is the focusing screw. This is the eyepiece, and this is the object glass. And here you can see 3 foot screws, 1, 2, 3, and a bubble tube at the top. I repeat, this is the telescope, focusing screw, eyepiece, object glass, 3 foot screws at the bottom, and the bubble tube. Before starting the survey work, we have to do the temporary adjustments of dummy level. There are 4 stages in the temporary adjustments of dummy level. The first one is setting up of the instrument, second one is leveling up, third one is focusing the eyepiece, and fourth one is focusing object glass. Now I explain the different steps. The first one is setting up. So for that, you have to find out a benchmark location near the spot you want to measure. So benchmark I will explain later, but time being you understand like this, it is a horizontal level surface. Then set up the tripod near the spot where the leveling is to be conducted. So this is the tripod. So you can adjust the height of the tripod, and then you have to clamp the instrument at the top of the tripod. So like this. Now it is tightened. So this is the first step. This is called setting up. Next is leveling up. So that is carried out with the help of these 3 foot screws. So what you have to do is you have to keep the telescope parallel to any 2 foot screws. Now the telescope is parallel to these 2 foot screws. Now the telescope is parallel to these 2 foot screws. Now the telescope is parallel to these 2 foot screws. So keep the telescope parallel to any 2 foot screws. Then rotate these 2 foot screws in the same direction like this. Rotate it in the same direction like this and bring the bubble to the center. So when I move this, the bubble is coming to the center. Then keep the telescope perpendicular to this axis, that means like this. And with the help of the 3rd foot screw, again bring the bubble to the center. When I move the foot screw, the bubble is coming to the center. Then go back to the previous position, check up whether the bubble is at the center. If it is not at the center, again carry out the same operation, and again check up whether the bubble is center at above the 3rd foot screw. Then the bubble will be center at all position. So this is called leveling up. The next step, that is focusing eyepiece. So this is the eyepiece. So you have to focus the eyepiece like this. Just turn it clockwise and anti-clockwise. When you turn like this, you will be able to see cross wires like this. For that, if you want, you can keep a white paper in front of the object glass and you can focus like this. So when I focus, I am getting the cross wires like this. So this is the 3rd step, that is focusing eyepiece. Next step, focusing object glass. This is the object glass. You have to sight the point. There you have to keep the leveling staff. Now I will show the leveling staff. So this is the leveling stuff. Actually, the height is 4 meter. You can see 1.1, from 1.1 to 2 point, up to 2 meter it can be extended. From 2 meter up to 3 meter it can be extended. From 3 meter up to 4 meter it can be extended. So it is a 4 meter height stub. Here you can see 1 meter is divided into 200 divisions. That means 100 white divisions and 100 black divisions, which means one division is 0.005 meters. Suppose when you sight through that telescope, if you are getting the crosswire at here, which means the reading is 1.2000. If it is here, 1.205. So like that, you have to read it and enter the reading. The leveling staff reading corresponding to the horizontal crosshair is noted. Now we'll move to some important definitions. Reduced level, benchmark, backsight, foresight, intermediate sight, line of sight or line of collimation, height of instrument, change point. All these terms are important. Now we'll see one by one. The first one is reduced level. All of you might have seen this name board in the railway station. The name of the place, it is written in Malayalam, Hindi and English. In addition to this, one more information is available on that board, that is this one. Here it is plus 4.04 meters. What it means? Which means that particular railway station, the railway track, it is situated at an height of 4.04 meters above the MSL. MSL means mean sea level. So MSL is taken as the datum or the reference line in survey. So that particular place, it is situated at an height of plus 4.04 meters. This 4.04 meters, that is called reduced level. So what is reduced level? So it is the height or the distance or the elevation. Elevation means that distance or the height. So it is the height or elevation or the distance from the mean sea level or from the datum. That is the definition for reduced level. Now next is benchmark. So if you know the reduced level of any place, say for example Calicut railway track, if you know the reduced level of Calicut railway track, you can call that point as the benchmark. If you know the reduced level of any place, that place can be called as benchmark. So what is benchmark? It is a known elevation point. So that means that distance is called reduced level, that point is called benchmark. Now we'll move to the next one, that is backsight. So if you want to find out the level difference between two points, say A and B, with the help of the leveling instrument, the procedure is like this. Set the instrument in between A and B. So I'll call that point as say O. Do all that preliminary operation, that is temporary adjustment, set it, level it, focus it, and keep the leveling staff at A. Sight through this and find where the crosswire is touching. So say this is X. Now keep the staff at B, rotate it and again sight it and get this height, say Y. Now the level difference between A and B is X minus Y or Y minus X, depends upon the height. Now here you see X is the first reading, Y is the last reading. The first reading taken by the instrument after setting up of the instrument, that is called backsight. So backsight is the first reading taken after setting up of the instrument. So next definition is foresight. Here you see this is the X is the first reading, Y is the last reading. The last reading is called foresight. So always remember like this, first reading will be always backsight, last reading will be foresight. The next definition, that is intermediate sight. Now in addition to A and B, if you want to find out the level difference of another point, say C, the procedure is like this. keep the instrument at what? Site A, take that reading, then site C, take that reading, say Z, height, that height is Z. Then site B, take that reading Y. Now we can compare the level difference of point C with A and B. So here X is the first reading, Y is the last reading, Z is the reading taken in between first reading and last reading. Such readings are called intermediate site. So the next definition, intermediate site, that is the reading taken in between back sight and foresight. Next definition, line of sight or line of collimation. When you set the instrument at O, after doing all the preliminary adjustments, that is temporary adjustments, there will be an imaginary horizontal axis passing through the eyepiece and the object glass, center of the eyepiece and center of the object glass. That imaginary axis is called line of sight or line of collimation. So next definition, line of sight or line of collimation. Imaginary horizontal axis passing through the center of the eyepiece and center of the object glass, that is called line of sight or line of collimation. Next, height of instrument. If I say the reduced level of A, what it means? It means reduced level, first definition, that is the height from the datum, from the sea level. So reduced level at A means elevation above the datum, elevation or height above the mean sea level. So the next definition, that is height of instrument, that is the elevation of the line of sight. Which is line of sight? This is line of sight. Elevation means it is always from the datum. In survey, the datum is taken as mean sea level. So elevation means this height, elevation of the line of sight. This is line of sight. Elevation of this point is means that is the reduced level, that is this height. Elevation of this axis means this height, that is called height of instrument. This is not height of instrument. In survey, height of instrument, it is from mean sea level or from the datum. So next definition, height of instrument, that is the elevation of the line of sight. Next definition is change point. Now in addition to A, B, C, if you want to find the level difference of another point, say D, somewhere here, if you keep the staff here, you may not get any reading because the maximum height is 4 meters. If that is the case, if you want to compare the elevation difference of D with B, C and A, the procedure is like this. After taking back sight, foresight, intermediate sight, shift the instrument from O to say another point, say O1. Do all the temporary adjustment, then sight back the previous point, that is at B. That is called back sight. What is the definition of back sight? It is the first reading taken after setting. So here for this setup, this is the first reading. Now sight D, get that reading, that is foresight. Foresight is the last reading. Now we can compare the elevation of D with A, B and C. Now here you see at B, a foresight is taken from O. At B, a foresight is taken from O. At B, a backsight is taken from O1. So at B, foresight is taken, backsight is taken. Such points are called change point. So next definition, change point. It is a point at which foresight as well as back sights are taken, which denotes the shifting up of the instrument. Next, methods of leveling. The first one is symbol leveling. Now I'll explain it here. Now there are two points A and B. The instrument is set in between A and B. Assume the back sight is say 1.600. So when you sight, you are assume you are getting a reading 1.6. Now sight the point B, assume you are getting a reading say 1.500. Now the level difference between A and B is 1.6 minus 1.5. Now if you know the reduced level, say at A is say 100.00 meters, assume, can you find out the reduced level at B? It is possible. How? Assume this is the mean sea level, MSL, the data, mean sea level. What is mean by reduced level? Reduced level means this height. Reduced level, it is the height above the datum. So this height is called reduced level. Backside means this height. What is HI? So this height is HI. It is the elevation of the line of sight. This is the line of sight. So this height is HI. This height is foresight. What is the reduced level at B? This is the reduced level at B. This height is the reduced level at B. So how to get that? What is the HI? HI at O. HI at O. HI means this height. What is that height? That is this height plus this. That is reduced level plus backside, which means 100 plus 1.6. Reduced level plus backside. That is 100.000 plus 1.600. That is 101.600. That is this height. Now foresight is known. Now what is that height, reduced level, that height? Reduced level at B. Reduced level at B. What is this height? That is this minus this. That is HI, height of instrument minus foresight. What is the height of instrument? 101.600 minus 1.500, which is equal to 100.100. So, which means if you know the reduced level of a point and the backside and foresight in between the first point and the last point, the reduced level of the last point can be calculated. This is called simple leveling. Hope it is clear for you. So here we are doing only one addition and one subtraction. That is, HI is equal to RL plus backside. Then to get the next RL, HI minus FS. Only this addition and subtraction will be doing throughout the leveling problem. So it is possible to calculate the reduced level of the second point if you know the reduced level of the first point and the backside and foresight in between the first point and the last point. But this may not be possible always. Say, for example, A here,
C somewhere here.
So if you keep a staff, you may not get any reading from O. That means if the elevation difference is too high, symbol leveling may not be possible. Or if A at Kalamacheri and say B at say Calicut, this method may not be possible. That means if the points are far away, or in between A and B, suppose there is an obstruction, one building is here, this method may not be possible. Three cases: if the elevation difference is too high, if the points are far away, and if there is any obstruction between two points, this simple leveling may not be possible. If that is the case, the next method, that is called fly leveling. Fly leveling. Or it is called continuous leveling, or it is called differential leveling. Next is fly leveling or differential leveling or continuous leveling. Assume first point here and the last point is far away, say B, somewhere here. Assume A at Kalamacheri, B at say Calicut or Bihar, wherever it is. Now, how to find out the level difference between A and B? The procedure is like this. Keep the staff here. Set the instrument somewhere here. Say O1. Sight this point. So, that reading is backside. Now, shift the staff from A to say C. Sight that point. That reading is foresight. Now, shift the instrument from O1 and keep it at the next station, say O2. Side back the previous point. That reading is backside. Backside is the first reading taken after setting up of the instrument. So here, new setup, this is the first reading, backside. Now shift the staff from C, keep it at D. Take that reading, that is foresight. Now shift the instrument from O2 and keep it at O3. Do all the preliminary operations. Side back, that is backside. Now shift the staff from B and keep it at B. Side that point is foresight. Now, if you know the reduced level of A, you can calculate the reduced level of B wherever it is. So, how? With reduced level of A, backside, is it possible to get the height of instrument at O1? It is possible. You will get the height of instrument at O1. With HI and foreside, get the reduced level at C. With this reduced level, backside, foreside, get the reduced level at D. Again, simple leveling. One simple leveling, another simple leveling, another simple leveling. So, with this reduced level, backside, get the HI. With this HI, this foreside, get the RL at D. With this RL, this backside, get the HI at O3. With this HI and foreside, get the RL at B. This is called continuous leveling or fly leveling or compound leveling. So, now we will do a problem. In the university examination, exactly you will get a problem like this. The following readings were taken, which are damping level. The instrument was shifted after taking the third and seventh readings. The first reading was taken on a benchmark of reduced level 100 meters. Find the reduced levels of all the points. Also apply the check. So, I will tell you what is that check. So, the readings are given starting from 1.895 to 3.115. So, first you have to write the readings. So, first you enter the readings like this. Now, you have to identify which all are the backside, which all are the foreside, which all are the intermediate side. One thing you know, first reading is backside. This will be always backside. Immediately you can write that is backside, and last reading will be always foreside. Now, in the question, it is given that after taking the third and seventh reading, the instrument was shifted. 1, 2, 3. After taking this reading, the instrument was shifted. So, this reading is a foreside. What is the definition of foreside? Foreside is the last reading taken before shifting up of the instrument. So, after taking this reading, the instrument was shifted, which means this is a foreside. So, if this is foreside, next is backside. Then it is given in the question, after taking the seventh reading, the instrument was shifted. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So, this reading is a foreside. After taking that reading, the instrument was shifted. So, next reading will be backside. All other readings in between backside and foresides are intermediate sides. Here one intermediate side. So, this is the first step. You have to identify which all are the backside, which all are the foreside, which all are the intermediate side. Now, you can just sketch that arrangement. The first reading taken from an instrument station. So, that reading is backside, that is 1.895. Here, foreside is taken, intermediate side is taken. So, foreside, I will mark foreside first, that is 1.865. Next, intermediate side. Intermediate side can be towards your forward direction or backward direction or towards your right side or towards your left side. To avoid confusion, I will mark the intermediate side here. That reading is 1.500. Now, the instrument is shifted to a new place and the previous staff is sighted back. That reading is 2.570. There are two intermediate sides. Two points are sighted as intermediate points. First reading is 990. Second reading is 2.020. Then the foreside 2.410. Same point, backside 2.52. So it will come somewhere here. 2.520. There also one intermediate side. 2.960. And the last reading is backside. Foreside 3.115. So now you have marked these readings in this sketch. Now give the names for the instrument station. Instrument station usually O1, O2 and O3. Staff stations, you can give any names. Say A, B, C, D, E, F, G, and H. Now the initial reduced level is given in the question as 100. If it is not given, you can assume the initial reduced level. So in this question, it is given as 100.00 meters. 100.00 meters. So what is the HI? HI at O1, that is reduced level, plus backside, that is 1.895, that is 101.895. With this reading, that is with this HI, two points are cited, B cited, C cited. So if you want to get the reduced level at C, HI minus this height, that is foresight. So if you want the reduced level at B, same HI minus that height, that is 1.500. So RL at B, 101.895 minus 1.500, that will come 100.395, that is the reduced level at B. Now to get the reduced level C, same HI, reduced level at C, 101.895 minus the reading at C, 1.865, that is coming as 100.030. Now you got the reduced level at C, proceed with the new reduced level, that is to get the HI at O2, reduced level at C, that is 100.030 plus backside 2.570, that is 102.600, that is the HI. Now with same HI, three points are cited, D, E and F. So reduce this reading to get the reduced level at D, deduct this reading to get the reduced level at E, deduct 2.41 to get the reduced level at F. So RL at D, HI 102.600 minus the reading at D, that is 2.990, that is 99.610. Reduced level at D. Now reduced level at E, same HI, 102.600 minus 2 point, reading at E is 2.020. The answer is 100.580. Now the reduced level RL at F, again same HI, that is 102.600 minus the reading at F, 2.410. The answer is 100.190. Now new reduced level, with this reduced level HI and next RI. So HI at O3, 100.190 plus 2.520, 102.710. Now the next RL at G, HI 102.710 minus 2.960, the answer is 99.750. Next reduced level at H, last point, same HI, 102.710 minus the last reading foresight, that is 3.115, the answer is 99.595. So with the reduced level at A100, with this so many foresight backside, we are getting the last reduced level, that is 99.595. Now you have to enter these readings in a tabular column. So this is the tabular column. So first staff stations, then readings. Readings can be backside, intermediate side, foresight, height of instrument, reduced level and remarks. So first you have to fill up the staff station. In our problem, the staff stations are First relation A, then B, C, D, E, F, G, and H. Now you see A. A, what reading is taken? That is 1.895, that is a backside. So enter it in the backside column, 1.895. Now B is an intermediate side. So you have to enter the reading at B, that is 1.500 against B. Next is C. C, there is foreside as well as backside. So first, foreside 1.865. And the same point, the backside is 2.570. Next, D. D is an intermediate side. The reading is 2.990. E, that is also an intermediate side. So enter in the intermediate side column. The reading is 2.020. Next, F. F, foreside is there as well as backside is there. So F against F in the foreside column, 2.410. And in the backside column, backside reading, that is 2.520. G, it is an intermediate side. The reading is 2.960. H is the last reading. The reading is 3.115. So like that, you have to enter the backside, intermediate side, and foreside. Now, and one more information available at A, that is the reduced level. So against A, in the RL column, enter that reading, 100.000. Now, you have to fill up the remarks column. So this one, against A, if you know the reduced level of any point, that point can be called as benchmark. So here you write BM. Now, at any point, foresights and backsides are taken. Such points are called change point. So this is one change point, CP1. One more change point is there, that is CP2. Now, you have to enter your observations, your findings one by one. The same order, if you enter, you won't commit any mistakes. So what is the first finding? That is HI at O1, that is 101.895. So that reading, you have to enter it here, 101.895. So what is the next finding? That is the reduced level at B. So against B, in the RL column, enter that reading, that is 100.395. What is the next finding? That is the reduced level at C. So against C, enter the reduced level which you got, that is 100.030. What is the next finding? That is HI at O2. That you have to enter against this column, HI at O2, that is 102.600. The next finding is RL at D. RL at D, against D, in the RL column, the value 99.610. Next finding is RL at E. RL at E is, we got 100.580. The next finding is RL at F, that is 100.190. The next finding is HI at O3. So that you have to enter against F, 102.710. Then the next finding is RL at G, that is 99.750. Next finding is RL at H, 99.595. Now here you see HI is same. Either you write it once again or you can mark it like this. Here HI is same, here HI is same. So like that you have to enter your finding. Now you can check up whether your answer is correct or not, your calculation is correct or not. For that, there is a check. Check sigma backside minus sigma foreside without considering the sign should be equal to the difference in first and last reduce levels. So you can check up now. Add these three readings, A, C and F. If you add, you will get 6.985. 6.985. Now sigma foresight, add these three readings, 1, 2, 3. If you add, you will get 7.390. That should be equal to the difference in first and last radius level. First radius level is 100.000 minus the last radius level is 99.595. So if you deduct, you will get 0.405 here, and here also 0.405. So your answer or your calculation is correct. This is what I actually asked in the question. Carry out the check. So this is the check. Sigma backside minus sigma foresight should be equal to the difference in first and last reduced level. So you have to, after completing the problem, you have to carry out the check also. Another problem. The following are the consecutive readings taken with a dummy level and a 4 meter long staff on a continuously sloping ground. Rule out a page of level field book and enter the readings. Also calculate the reduced levels of each session. The reduced level of the first point is 100 meters and the readings are given. So here the problem is, it is not given when the instrument was shifted. So instead of that, another clue is given, that is, it is on a continuously sloping ground. So how to identify which all are the backside, which all are the foreside? Listen here. So what will happen on a sloping ground? If you are taking the readings on a sloping ground, if you are keeping the instrument here, and when you sight a point, you may get this height, say X. If you keep the instrument here, when you sight, you will get, say, Y. If you keep the staff here and you sight, you will get this reading, say, Z. So here you can see, Z is greater than Y, Y is greater than X. So in a sloping ground, the readings will increase. Once you shift the instrument, if you shift the instrument from, say, O1 to, say, O2, then if you sight back, you will get another reading, say, Z dash. Z dash will be less than Z. So the reading will continuously increase and suddenly it will decrease. So enter, rewrite the readings like this. First reading you can immediately write, that is backside. Last reading is foreside. So since it is given, it is on a sloping ground, you see the readings are increasing. 0.700, 1.100, 1.950, 2.900, sudden decrease. 1.00. From 2.9, it is reduced to 1.000. That means after taking this reading, after taking 2.900, the instrument was shifted. So this reading is foreside. So next reading is backside. Again, the readings are increased. 1.550, 2.250, 3.750, sudden decrease, 0.850, which means after taking this reading, the instrument was shifted. So this is foreside. Next is backside. All other readings are intermediate sight. So like that, you identify which all are the foresight, which all are the backsight, which all are the intermediate sight. Now we have identified which all are the backsight, which all are the foresight, which all are the intermediate sight. Now we enter, as in the previous case, like this. Backsight, intermediate, foresight, HI, reduced level, enter the remarks. Now draw that figure and calculate the reduced level of each session point and enter it like this. Or directly you can enter here without drawing that figure. Reduced level plus backside HI, HI minus IS, next reduced level, HI minus this IS, next reduced level, HI minus foresight, reduced level plus backside HI. Like that also you can calculate and enter it like this. And finally, the arithmetic check, sigma backside minus sigma foresight should be equal to the difference in first and last reduced level. 2.550 is sigma backside and sigma foresight is 9.650, which is equal, should be equal to 92.900, that is the last reduced level minus first reduced level. The answer is 7.100. So for winding up, today we have discussed the different terms and the different instruments used: level, leveling staff, reduced level, benchmark, backsight, foresight, intermediate sight, line of sight, height of instrument, change point, etc. Then we have done the problem also. So in the problem, either they may say when the instrument was shifted. If that is the case, that point should be the foresight, next point should be the backsight. Or it may say it is on the sloping ground. In sloping ground, you have to see where the readings are changing. So that highest reading will be the foresight, next lowest reading will be the backsight. And sometimes there may be three shifting. So instrument was shifted after taking third, seventh and tenth reading. If that is the case, that third, seventh and tenth reading are the foresights. That's all. Hope it is clear for you. Thank you.